بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أيها الإخوة المسلمون Brothers and sisters in Islam, a statement which is very profound said by one of the early scholars, the statement is, I quote him, إِنَّ مِنْ أَوْسَعِ أَوْدِيَةِ الْبَاطِلِ الْغُلُوُّ فِي الْأَفَاضِلِ إِنَّ مِنْ أَوْسَعِ أودية الباطل الغلو في الأفاضل. One of the means, the translation, one of the means to falsehood, to misguidance, is to exaggerate the status of pious people. Again, one of the means to fall into misguidance, to adopt falsehood, is to exaggerate the status of good people, of pious people, whether they are prophets, messengers, or awliya, that you turn them from being slaves to Allah to objects of worship, that you worship them. وَهَذَا هُوَ مَبْدَأُ الشِّرْكِ فِي الْأَرْضِ. And this is how shirk, which is the opposite of the name of that blessed masjid, Tawheed, shirk, started in earth. الإمام البخاري في كتاب التفسير, just go home tonight and Google ابن كثير سورة نوح, chapter نوح, and look into the تفسير of the verse وقالوا لا تذرن آلهتكم ولا تذرن ودا ولا سواعا ولا يغوث ويعوق ونسرا. After Prophet Nuh alayhi salam spent almost 950 years calling those people to Tawheed, at the end they said, we're not gonna abandon the worship of the following: Waddan, Suwa'an, Yaghuth, Ya'uq, wa Nasra. These are idols. But who are those people? They used to be righteous and pious people in the community. The people loved them. They thought they are very special. When they died, they missed them. Shaitan came and inspired them to erect status, mausoleums, their shapes around their graves. Be careful, those people who erected these statues, these objects, did not worship them. See, Shaitan is to live until the day of judgment. He has time. He has a base. He told them, listen guys, don't erect these statues to worship them. No, just to remember them. You guys miss them. You miss them. Just remember them. Who worshiped them? Their children. When knowledge disappeared, the knowledge of Tawheed disappeared, and the children used to remember their parents looking into these statues with respect, with honor. So they said, man, these objects must have something special. And they turned into their worship. Imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to them a prophet who spent 950 years to abandon the worship of these pious people. They wouldn't do it. This type of shirk, ya ikhwa, the scholars call it shirkul mahabba. You know, major shirk has many types, but the most famous of them is shirkul du'a, shirkul ta'a, shirkul iradati wal qasd. But the one I'm looking for, that you love someone so much to the extent that you give them precedence, you give them status above Allah. And this is the first type of shirk which is emerged into earth. And you want to know something interesting? Our friends in humanity, our co-workers, our neighbors, that good John, Patricia, they fallen into that type of shirk too. The shirk of mahabba, excessive love for Jesus. They love him. And this is, by the way, one of the most difficult things. That is why when you approach them, you have to approach them what? In a very kind, nice way. وجاء هذا في القرآن وَلَا تُجَادِلُوا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ إِلَّا بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala referred to the type of shirk in the Quran. In Surah Al-Baqarah, when he says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَتَّخِذُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ أَنْدَادًا يُحِبُّونَهُمْ كَحُبِّ اللَّهِ. And there are some from mankind who take beside Allah rivals, they love them as much or more than their love for Allah. Well, that's the danger. You see, who is the best person that we must love? Rasulullah. But you want to know something? You cannot love Rasulullah more than you love Allah. And your love to Rasulullah is a branch of your love to Allah. Pay attention to this, brothers. You cannot love a created being more than your love for Allah. What is the manifestation of this love if you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If you truly love Allah, one of the signs that you don't insult Allah or you do not accept someone to insult Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in front of you. If you truly love Allah, you should not accept during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, some of the companions used to curse the idols of the disbelievers. They would go and curse Lat wal Uzza. Now, the disbelievers would respond with cursing Allah. So they would curse Allah. Allah said to the Muslims, what? ولا تسبوا الذين يدعون من دون الله فيسبوا الله عدوا بغير ان تقول. Stop doing this. Don't curse the idols, because the consequences of you cursing the idols, they curse Allah. فدون دو ات فيسبوا الله عدوا بغير علم كذلك زينا لكل أمة عملهم. They don't know anything about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, I'll give you two examples of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companion Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu, hearing insulting words about Allah in front of them, just to show you how much they loved Allah. في مستدرك الحاكم, a book, الحاكم أبو عبد الله النيسابوري, he looked into the ahadith which Al-Bukhari wa Muslim did not compile. Meanwhile, the same criteria are existing, and he compiled these ahadith. This hadith is mentioned في مستدرك الحاكم, the narrator of Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهما. جاءت يهود إلى الرسول صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم يسألونه عن خلق السماوات والأرض. A group of Jewish rabbis came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم asking him regarding the creation of the heavens and the earth. Allah subhanahu, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth in 6 days. The hadith is lengthy. I don't want to get into the details there. He actually detailed for them. He created the earth on a Sunday and the mountains on a Tuesday. Then he stopped after 6 days. Then the Jewish rabbis looked to him and they said, ثُمَّ مَاذَا, then what? He said, then he rose above the throne in a way that suits his majesty. نقرأ هذا في القرآن. We recite this in the Quran. الله الذي خلق سبع سماوات الذي خلق سبع سماوات وما بينهما في ستة أيام ثم استوى على العرش. Then he rose above the throne in a way that suits his majesty. They said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, asabta, everything that you said is correct except one thing. He rested in the seventh day, which is a sentence you all hear from Christian and Jews. Look at the reaction of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam to something that a lot of us don't even move a hand for. غضب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم غضبا شديدا. He looked angry. Why? This is an insult. Some of you may not conceive it. You see, if you say Allah rests, you're saying Allah gets tired. Subhana. Does Allah get tired? Jibreel comes down with the verse in Surah Qaf, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامٍ وَمَا مَسَّنَا مِنْ لُغُوبٍ فَاصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ. Created the heavens and the earth in what between them in 6 days, and no fatigue ever approached me. Be patient about what they say about me. You want another example of love for Allah? That verse that I shared with you, that there are those who appoint created beings, even though they are pious and righteous. You see, Prophet Isa is innocent of this. And on the day of judgment, he will disclaim everything they say about him. وَإِذْ قَالَ اللَّهُ يَا عِيسَى بِنَ مَرْيَمَ. Allah will say to him in front of his followers, those who claim to be his followers, أَأَنْتَ قُلْتَ لِلنَّاسِ اتَّخِذُونِي وَأُمِّيَ إِلَهَيْنِ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ. Did you tell, instruct those people to take you and your mother as two gods beside me? قَالَ سُبْحَانَكَ. Subhanak, you're above that. مَا يَكُونُ لِي أَنْ أَقُولَ مَا لَيْسَ لِي بِحَقٍ إِن كُنْتُ قُلْتُهُ فَقَدْ عَلِمْتَ. How can I say such a thing, basically? Look at the other example, brothers and sisters in Islam. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, someone who loves Allah, loves his messenger. You know, a lot of us sometimes, when someone says something about Rasulullah, we get upset, which is fine, which is right. That's a sign of love for Rasulullah. But we should feel the same way about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One day, wal-athar akhrajahu Ibn Jarir al-Tabari fi tafsirihi wa Ibn Abi Hatim min kalam Abdullah ibn Abbas. Sa'id ibn Jubair is the one who narrated the author. One day, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiyallahu an stopped by the school where the Jews are teaching the Torah. You know, like we have our weekend school. So he arrived and he found a very popular, famous Jewish rabbi by the name of Finhas. That's his name. And the people are surrounding him. And he is teaching them the Torah. Abu Bakr and Finhas knew one another, so there was a level of communication. So Abu Bakr approached Finhas and he said to him, "Wayhak, Aslim, become a Muslim. You know that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is written in your Torah. Become a Muslim." See what Finhas said? "I will not believe in a God who accepts usury, meanwhile makes it unlawful for us to accept usury." Shall I say this again? So Allah Himself takes usury, riba, meanwhile it's not allowed for us to accept usury. How did he reach that understanding? In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Man dhalladhi yuqridu Allah qardan hasanan fayudha'ifahu lahu adha'afan kathira." If you give Allah a loan, Allah will give it back to you manifold, many. That's usury, that's the definition of usury, but not with Allah. Allah doesn't need that. What is meant, He will give it back to you in reward. He will bless you. You see, a Muslim with the proper understanding of who Allah is will not reach that twisted understanding of the verse. And this is why, ya ikhwah, watch people who make tafsir of the Quran. Find out their belief system first. Because according to their beliefs, they will twist the words to accommodate their beliefs. What was the reaction of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq? He slapped him. Imagine Abu Bakr, the peaceful, the harmless. Read his biography. He couldn't take it. He's telling you, "Your Allah is poor. Your Allah is poor. He needs a loan. And he gives you encouragement, incentive that he couldn't take it. Finhas immediately rushed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. انظر ما فعل صاحبك. Look what your companion, what your sahib did to me. Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, being the leader, he has to be fair and judge to everybody. You see, he's the head of the community in Medina, and there are Jews, there are Christians, there are Muslims. He has to be fair. He has to investigate the matter. Come here. Why did you do this, Ya Aba Bakr? He said, Ya Rasul Allah, qala qawlan azima. He said something that I could not hold myself back. He said, Allah is poor and we are rich. Finhas denied the fact that he said that. He said, I never said that. Jibreel comes down with the verses.
لقد سمع الله قول الذين قالوا إن الله فقير ونحن أغنياء.
Allah has heard the statement of those who said Allah is poor and we are rich. سنكتب ما قالوا. We will write it down. وقتلهم الأنبياء بغير حق. And they're killing of the prophets and messengers in reference to Ahlul Kitab. I go back to the subject here. I don't want to get off track. One of the signs that you love Allah, that you don't accept an insult, you don't tolerate an insult, and dare you think that I'm encouraging you to react in any manner. No. But at least move about it. Have some reaction about it. Now, brothers and sisters in Islam, our larger community, they are going through celebrations, which is Christmas. Now, what Christmas is about, and you know, people like myself, we always get these questions. Should I say Merry Christmas? Should I give a gift? Should I exchange gifts? Should I go to a Christmas party? Should I get Christmas bone? All type. We have a whole package of Christmas questions, like Halloween questions, Christmas questions. Eid in February, love, the red thing. Valentine, subhanAllah, we as people who answer questions to people, we have them now. Okay, this is the time for Christmas. Open up. Classical, repeated every time. I'm not going to tell you what to do, but I'm going to share with you Quran and Sunnah. قال الله قال رسول الله. That's it. And you make your judgment. الحديث في صحيح البخاري. The narrator is Abu Huraira. The one who is speaking in this hadith is Allah. This is what we call hadith Qudsi. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, Allah سبحانه وتعالى says, شتمن ابن آدم. The son of Adam insults me. وما ينبغي له ذلك. He shouldn't have done that. كذبني ابن آدم. The son of Adam belies me. وما ينبغي له ذلك. He shouldn't have done that. أما شتمه إياي. As for the son of Adam insulting me, فقوله أن لي ولد. When he says that I have a son, وأنا الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. I'm not gonna even insert one word of my statements, Quran and Sunnah. I'm not gonna say anything. You make your judgment. And as for the son of Adam belying me, him saying that I cannot raise him up again after he is dead. Look at the reaction of the elements of the universe when they hear that statement, brothers and sisters in Islam, that Allah has a son. And like I promised, only Quran and Sunnah. I'm not going to say my own words. So you don't say that Sheikh is fanatic. And listen, I live in America for 25 years. I know my boundaries. And there is a misconception in the minds of a lot of Muslims, which is, for you to show that you're progressive, that you're open, that you're civilized, that you're not fanatic, you have to compromise your beliefs. I'm sorry, you're wrong. You don't have to. You don't have to. Who said that? You don't have to. I'll give you something very interesting. You know that there are Christians, Middle East Christians, they call them the Orthodox, the Salafi brand. And there are the Western, the European, the open one. You see, the religion, they're trying to tweak Islam to, you know, American Islam and Islam there. Do you know that Christmas for the Orthodox Muslims, the Middle Eastern guys, where Christianity started, in what day? January 7th, not December 25th. The European is December 25th. Wallahi, I read this in their own literature. It is haram for an Orthodox Christian to say Merry Christmas to another Christian who celebrates Christmas on the 25th. Imagine this. And I'm not talking about Muslims. I'm talking about Christian with what? For you to take a break from what I'm trying to say and not to exert your brains with me, memorize this line. Tolerance is not in beliefs. Being tolerant is in interacting with them. التسامح في المعاملات وليس في العقائد. You being tolerant has to do with interacting with them. How you doing, ma'am? How's it going? You know, she's carrying that shopping bag. Can I carry? I'll carry the shopping bag for you, ma'am. Can I loan your mom the snow? You guys don't have snow here. We have snow in Colorado. Can I help you with the snow? Huh? That's tolerance. How you doing? Good to see you. Have a nice day. That's tolerance. Birr. We call this birr. But nobody there says that for you to be tolerant, that you go and you compromise your beliefs. Nobody said that. Nobody says that. Nobody said that. And by the way, Americans don't expect you to do this. Actually, they have high regard for you when they know that you believe in something. But let me go back to the Quran, and I'm sorry I broke my promise. I thought I'm not going to say anything from my words. But look at the Quran now. Look, Surah Maryam, a chapter called Maryam. وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ الرَّحْمَانُ وَلَدًا. They say Rahman begets a son. The kalam Allah. لَقَدْ جِئْتُمْ شَيْئًا إِدَّا. What an awful thing to say about Allah. شوف. تكاد السماوات يتفطرن منه, أي من قولهم. The heaven is about to break. The heaven is about to break because of them saying that. وتنشق الأرض, the earth is about to split open. وتخر الجبال هدا, and the mountains about to fall down. Why? أن دعوا للرحمن ولدا. Because الرحمن, because they say الرحمن has a son. وما ينبغي للرحمن أن يتخذ ولدا. Analyze it with me. Why you and me need to have children? Analyze it. Number one, because my last name is AbuZaid. When I go to the grave, AbuZaid is going to die with me. So I want a child who will carry on what? Does Allah die? You answer me. Subhana. Allah doesn't die.
Allah doesn't need someone to carry on his name after him. Does Allah need that? That's why it's an insult. What else? Because you need someone to inherit your wealth. You worked hard, $10 million. Does Allah die again? You need someone to help you when you grow old. You know, when we get old, have gray hair, we need the kids to take care of us. Does Allah need someone to take care of them? Shahid, brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above all of this. And you as a Muslim should stand for that. But again, we should do this in a respectful way, in a kind way, in a polite way. And hopefully after that short break, I'll explain to you how. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه أمهات المؤمنين وعلى من اتبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Brothers and sisters in Islam, in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressed this subject overwhelmingly in a way that is out of this world. And go through the Quran, every time that subject is mentioned, you always find subhanak, subhan. The word subhanallah means that you're above that, ya Rabb. Now, obviously, the Christians concluded that Allah has a son because of a reason. That Prophet Isa, alayhi salatu wasalam, was born without a father. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses them. And there was a whole delegation called the delegation of Najran who came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, and they debated regarding the status of Prophet Isa, and they brought this subject up. Allah answered them with this question: إن مثل عيسى عند الله كمثل آدم خلقه من تراب ثم قال له كن فيكون. Why are you saying Isa is the son of Allah? Because he did not have a father. Adam did not have a father nor a mother. What about Eve? She had a father, no mother. Allah is able to do everything. Brothers and sisters in Islam, a piece of advice from your brother. Don't try to correct people when they are joying or when they are grieving. Those are two moments that you don't want to interrupt the rhythm. That is why the work of da'wah has to be done ahead of time. You see, right now you learned that Merry Christmas as if you're condoning it. They are celebrating the birthday of the Son of Allah. And you saying it, you contributing in it, you participating in it as if you're condoning it. Now, should I wait until Christmas comes and upset people? No. You should do the da'wah ahead of time. Listen, I'm a Muslim. In no way I'm disrespecting you. You're my neighbor. You're my co-worker. I respect you. I can't force you to follow my way. But you, me participate. So you should do the education ahead of time. So that when the season comes, they expect you to behave in that way. So that they do not feel weird about it. So that they do not think that you are, in a way, against them. No. This is not the scenario here. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless this ummah with the proper guidance so that we show our love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this part of the world. Brothers and sisters in Islam, you as parents, if you compromise these simple things, guess what? Guess what? Your children are watching you. They will compromise more and more and more. And at the end, Islam will vanish from America. We need to stand for what we believe in a respectful, polite, kind way, which is the Muslim way to begin with. Brothers and sisters in Islam, let me close with that verse, and I'm done with this. وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودُ عُزَيْرٌ ابْنُ اللَّهِ. The Jews, they say, Uzair is the son of Allah. وَقَالَتِ النَّصَارَى الْمَسِيحُ ابْنُ اللَّهِ. And the Christians, they say, المسيح عيسى بن مريم is the son of Allah. Look, 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 look. يُضَاهِئُونَ قَوْلَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ قَبْلِ. They are imitating the people before them. قاتلهم الله أن يؤفكون. This is a big lie. اتخذوا أحبارهم ورهبانهم أربابا من دون الله والمسيح ابن مريم وما أمروا إلا ليعبدوا إلها واحدا. They were commanded to worship Allah. And that is why you came to America. And that's why you're here, to help them rectify that distorted belief. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala al-qawm al-kafirin. Allahumma arina al-haqqa haqqan wa arzuqna attiba'a wa arina al-batila batilan wa arzuqna ijtinaba. Allahumma waffiqna ila ma tuhibbu wa tarda wa khudh bi nawasina ila al-birri wa taqwa. Allahumma ij'alna hudatan mahdiyin. Allahumma ij'alna hudatan mahdiyin. Allahumma ihdina wa ihdi bina wa ij'alna sababan liman ihtada. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum.
ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا.